The Canterbury Championship meet continues. It's day number two, and it's a Thursday, June 11th. Let's take a look at that prime time pick four at Canterbury as it starts with race 5, 6, 7, and 8. And as we talked about yesterday, early on in the meet, I'm trying to just find some horses that can offer a little bit of a price. I will never recommend 4 chalks or even 3 chalks in any sequence. What I'm trying to do is look for those $1,000 and up pick fours for 50 cents. If you watch yesterday's video, I had the 2 long shots, 15-1 in both the spread races, just missed on the couple of favorites in the other 2 legs. Hopefully it helped you out today. Let's start off with Finn Country. And this is kind of going to be my key to the today's sequence. I think as I do multiple tickets, I want this guy. I think he's got some fast works. I like the way that he's drawn in this spot. And I think if Finn Country gets a good trip, that could start off this pick four, which I think a lot of tickets are going to be going a little bit deeper. And I'm going to kind of take a stand with number 5, Finn Country, in race number 5. We move along to race 6. This one's another one that I think's got a bunch of Oaklawn shippers, and I'm not sure how the handicappers are going to treat them. I think Seekin' Justice, number 7, he's going to be my top selection. Ships in from Oaklawn Park, and I think he has a sneaky trip to back that looks like he could be live in this spot. Starring John Wayne is another one who I think offers some value at the odds and won't be included on as many tickets. So I'm going to go 2 deep in race 6. Race 7, I'm going to make a stand with King of the Court, although he's not as much of a key in my tickets as Finn Country is. Another horse to consider in here is Jerry's Pride and Joy. That would be my 2nd selection if I had to go 2 deep. But I really like King of the Court. Inside draw, 6.5 furlongs. I think he can come from off the speed and get first run on some of the other horses who may be going wide on the turn coming into the stretch. And then I'm going to close it out. I think the spread race today is that final race. This is where I think the long shot's going to be found. I'm not happy with the favorites here in race number 8. So I'm going to narrow it down to these 3. I like Sassy Seda, Smoking Hot Mama, and Cause to Wonder. It's, remember, 5 furlongs on the turf. You're going to want to be in position, and jockeys play a key role on the turf course at Canterbury. It just seems like there's always those jockeys that seem to get into trouble. This will be the first turf race of the year. Tonight, and we'll see how it wraps up here with Sassy Seda, my top selection, but I also like Smoking Hot Mama as my other A horse in this sequence. Remember, we're not looking for mothers, we're looking for horses that can show some speed and stick. And again, my spread race is race number 8. I'm looking for, when I go deep, when you see me with more horses in a leg, that means I'm not as confident in the favorites. And what I'm looking for is those $1,000 pick fours. I'm never going to recommend 4 favorites. If you're looking for those type of tickets, you can go to Superstats Dave. He puts out a lot of favorites on his tickets. Or the Oracle. He'll give you some of those favorites, but not Derbyologist. He's looking for those $1,000 pick fours. I'm looking for the value. And we'll see what happens here as we mow the lawn in race number 8. Day number 2 of Canterbury.